I'm reading from 1 Samuel.
Samuel
chapter 1.
Ori kini.
From insult to miracle. 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 1. We want to pick up a few lessons from the life of a very remarkable Bible woman. First Samuel chapter 1 from verse 1. Now there was a certain man of Ramathaizophim of Mount Ephraim. His name was Elkanah, the son of Jeroham, the son of Elihu, son of Tou, son of
Sufu,
and Ephrathite. And he had two wives. The name of the first one was Anna, and the second one Penina. And Penina had children, but Hannah had no children. And this man went up out of the city yearly to worship and to sacrifice from the Lord of hosts in Shiloh.
And
the two sons of Eli, Ophini and Phineas, the priests of the Lord, were there. And when the time was that Elkanah offered, he gave Penina his wife and to all her sons and daughters portions.
But
to Anna, he gave a worthy portion, for he loved Anna, but the Lord had shut up her womb.
And
her adversary also provoked her soul. But to make her fret, because the Lord has shut up her womb. And as did so year by year, when she went up to the house of the Lord, so she provoked her. Therefore she wept and did not eat. Then said Elkanah, her husband, to her, Anna, why weepest thou? Why eatest thou not? Why is
that
outraged? Am I not better to thee than 10 sons? Anna rose up after they had eaten in Shiloh, after they had drunk. Now Eli the priest sat upon the seat by the post of the temple of the Lord. And she was in bitterness of soul and prayed unto the Lord and wept sore. And she vowed a vow and said, O Lord of hosts, if thou wilt indeed look on the affliction of the handmaid and remember me, and not forget the handmaid, but will give unto thy handmaid a man child, then I will give him unto the Lord all the days of his life, and there shall no razor come upon his head. And it came to pass as he continued praying before the Lord that Eli marked her mouth. Now Anna, she prayed in her heart, only her lips moved, but her voice was not hard. Therefore, Eli thought she had been drunking. And Eli said unto her, how long will thou be drunken? Put away thy wine from thee. Imagine somebody went to the temple to pray, and the priest is saying you are drunk. And Anna answered and said, no, my Lord, I'm a woman of sorrowful spirit. I've drunk neither wine nor strong drink, but I've poured out my soul before the Lord. Have not an handmaid for the daughter of Belial? But out of the abundance of my complaint and grief have I spoken either. Then Eli answered and said, go in peace. And the God of Israel granted thy petition that thou asked of him. And she said, let the handmaid find grace in thy sight. So the woman went away and did eat, and her countenance was no more sad. And he rose up in the morning early and worshipped before the Lord and returned. And came to the house in Ramah. And Elkanah knew Anna his wife, and the Lord remembered her. Elkanah knew his wife, and the Lord remembered her. Wherefore it came to pass, when the time was come about after Anna had conceived, that she bare a son, and called his name Samuel, saying, because I've asked him of the Lord. From insults to miracles. Anna was a woman insulted in the house. Bombarded with insults in the house. And she ran to the temple of God to pray. Praying her heart out. Then she did not know
why
that there was an enemy standing right at the edge of her breakthrough to provoke her. At the edge of that breakthrough, there is a battle known as the battle of provocation at the edge of breakthrough. When the person is close to that breakthrough, the enemy organizes something to provoke the person. To cheat the person from that breakthrough. Even at that time, you cannot see beyond the provocation.
So
this provocation is from the enemy. That will have silenced the breakthrough forever. First lesson you pick from Anna then.
Yeah,
she was a broken woman. Ordinary people ordinarily will have lost their temper with that priest. So what do you mean? Is it because I came to this place? Look at you. Call yourself a priest. And you don't even have spiritual eyes to see that I'm not drunk. And you are just insulting me. Do you know that? No. Look at the answer of that woman.
Said,
no, my Lord. I'm not drunk.
Said,
I'm speaking from the bitterness of my heart.
Said,
my Lord, don't take your daughter as a daughter of Belial. I'm not drunk. The same
Eli
that was used to provoke her to anger or to provoke, to insult her, was the same man who pronounced the blessings that eventually gave her a miracle. So if she had insulted that priest, and the priest and she got angry and walked out, there will be priest worship with the kingdom of darkness. And yes, we couldn't stop her from praying, but we were able to push her away from the altar of breakthrough. Many people sometimes come to church like this. After they have received massive breakthroughs, the enemy waits for them at the car park. The enemy waits for them on the road. The enemy waits for them even when they get home. And if they cannot see beyond that provocation,
That
is the level many people lose their breakthrough. They pray until they are sweating.
And
they say, don't worry, be sweating, be praying
there.
I know how to get you. They leave the prayer meeting. Something happens. They lose their temper. Some even fight. Creating praise worship. In the kingdom of darkness, we got him. We got her. We got him. We got her. Listen and listen to me carefully, beloved. If anger is in your life, your problem is more than all the witches and wizards in Nigeria put together. Your problem is more than somebody hit by a trailer. Because that anger is the demon at the door.
Because
you lose your temper like that, the door is open. And
they'll
be inviting other spirits to come in. In deliverance, we call anger the demon at the door. Opens the door. Say, I blood pressure, come inside. When you now calm down and you are no longer angry and the door closes again, those demons are already inside. It is a great battle. Provocation at the edge of breakthrough. Some complaints. Why is it that? It's when I pray high, people annoy me.
Oh,
they will annoy you. Because they want to steal what you have. What they cannot steal by direct attack. Steal it by indirect attack. Some are praying for serious breakthrough. Only to get home. You find that the maid, the security, the driver has done something wrong. That is exactly what the enemy is waiting for. And the person loses that breakthrough. You want to move from insult to miracle? Then you must take care of this provocation at the edge of breakthrough. There was another woman in the New Testament that came to Jesus.
Say,
Jesus, hit my daughter, he still killed my daughter. Jesus said, it is not fit that we take the food of children and give it to dogs. That was an insult. But at the same time, a pest. But thank God, just like Anna, the woman passed. I said, Master. Yes. So for sometimes, food will fall from the table, and the dog will eat the crumbs. The same Jesus that said it's not good to give food of children to dogs. Said, woman, great is thy faith.
I've not found
such a faith in Israel. But ordinarily, people have gotten angry. So what? You call me a dog? Is it because I asked you to pray for me? And that will have been the end of that testimony. There will be no miracle. I'm praying for somebody here. All those powers that have been using this method to steal from you, every provocation at the edge of breakthrough, I pull them down in the name of Jesus. I pull them down in the name of Jesus. I pull them down in the name of Jesus. And you see, it's easy to control anger. It's easy. Once You have been provoked. Don't talk. Just padlock your mouth. Once you do not talk, that your anger will die stillborn. Will die stillborn, not born at all. But if you open the mouth, that is exactly what he wants you to do. You open the mouth and begin to talk, then you are feeding it. You are feeding it. You are feeding it. Then it will be stronger. Then it will be stronger. To be stronger. To be stronger. And this is the way. And I want you to understand it very well. Many women who are beaten up by husbands, it's because they do not have the ministry of mouth padlock. Once you padlock your mouth, the words that will cause beating will not come out. And sometimes, you go there and say, Joe, he was talking. He started talking from ATM. Talk. Abuse my father, abuse my mother, abuse everything. So I didn't say anything. I just said one word. I said, what was that one word?
He
said, I said, you are as useless as your father.
He
said, that one word you spoke has canceled everything he's been saying for 4 hours. The minister of mouth
padlock.
It's very relevant these days. A lot of transactions take place when we come for prayer meetings. Transactions on which the enemy cannot do anything against. Unless you hand the control over to the enemy. Can you raise up your right hand again? And shout this louder than anyone around you. I move from instant to miracle by the power in the blood of Jesus. Shout it 3 times. One more time. Amen.
Amen.
So, lesson number one.
For you know, echo kini
refuse to be provoked.
Echo from
Munyebino at the edge of your
breakfast.
You learn that lesson from Anna.
Echo yi lato do Anna unletiko.
The second lesson, the second character we can pick from this woman.
Echo kiti ti aliko lato do yon
shi. That moved out from insults to miracle.
Was
that when she had problem of barrenness, she ran to the house of God, not to evil altars or
shrines.
She went to God when she had trouble. Not to evil altars or shrines. I was praying with a woman some time ago.
I
was looking for the foot of the woman. She told me she slept by a river for 7 days.
She told me that
3 times. Prophet. Bathed her by the sea.
More
once. She dressed up to go to a place. She took all the clothes and threw it into the running stream. She had eaten a concoction of rats and porridge before. Yet. No answer. People run about like that. There are some people who run about like that. We call them mosquito Christians. Mosquito from place to place. Instead of them to sit down and develop themselves. To sit down to read the Bible. Read down to spend 1 hour, 2 hours praying in tongues. Go like mosquito all over the place. Anna was not like that. She went to God when she had trouble. Two.
Because
Anna. Three. Anna persisted in prayers.
Anna, what does she do? Nino Adura big bang.
Number one, she refused to be provoked. Two.
Because
she went to God in her tribulation.
Sarah, don't lost your dollar on any point.
Three. She persisted in prayer. The Bible says she did not give up hope of becoming a mother. She went to Shiloh year after year. Year after year. Some other women in our situation will have stopped going to church. Every year, you are going first year. The woman at home had the first child, the second child, the third child, and she kept going. She will have given up and said, well, what's the sense? This woman, Anna, knew how to pray the prayer of enough is enough. After the ceremony was finished, she refused to leave the presence of God. She stayed there in that place crying to God until she received divine attention. Heaven is looking for Anna of this generation. Not those people are vagabonds in the school of prayer. They're looking for Anna of this generation that will persistently shake the hands of God, shake heavens and get results. So Anna was a prayer warrior. I'm praying for somebody here. The anointing to pray to the level that gets results. Receive it now in the name of Jesus. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. One, she refused to be provoked to anger. Do you have the spirit of anger? Bind it and cast it out. And from today, decide that no matter how badly provoke you, how badly they provoke you, you keep your mouth shut. Shut up the mouth. Then the anger dies. Two. She went to God. Not to alter her
shrine.
She was persistent and adamant in prayer. Persistent and adamant prayer. She even prayed crying. Unfortunately, in our days, we have plenty of psychedelic Christians who cannot pray their way out of any affliction. They cannot stay in the altar of prayer for too long. But they can watch Nollywood. 2 hours. Part one. Part two. Part three. 4 hours. But cannot pray. Non stop. For 30 minutes. And then you are asking for uncommon breakthroughs. Won't happen that way. the life is just structured like that.
Mm-hmm.
Some people will not marry just like that.
Some will
not get children just like that. Some will not get a job just like that. Some will not win that contract just like that. Others will marry just like that. Others will have children just like that. Others will get the contract just like that.
But
those just like that people are a small category.
The
minority. Majority will have to pursue the lion and rescue what that lion has stolen from the mouth of the lion. Majority will have to be like David and run after the lion that took the lamb and get the lamb, pull it out of the mouth of that lion. Because many people, before they were even born, whatever will make them prosper is already captured. They've already taken it away. Some they take it away from the womb. Some when they are alive. Some through all kinds of tribulations. And if you are born and you are unlucky to have prayerless parents, you could have lost so many things. So many will not get things like that. Life is not fair. It is you who would demand that that life has to be fair to you.
So
have a lot of psychedelic Christians. They don't want to stay long in the place of prayer. They even go to preach as who tell you that there is nothing like prayer world, no need to pray. Don't worry. Put yourself and the preacher saying there is no need to pray. Everybody is becoming to pray. When you understand what is going on, the Bible did not say preach without ceasing. This is sing without
sin.
This is witness without sin.
But
pray
without sin.
The men ought always to pray and not preach. I pray one more time that the anointing to pray your way to breakthroughs. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Let the heaven roar like thunder. Receive that anointing. Receive it. In the name of Jesus. 4. Anna was always fasting. She knew she needed to make a sacrifice in order to receive her deliverance. These days, princess find it difficult to fast. Their belly is becoming their god. Some people only fast because there is no food in the house. Not because they want to fast. Whereas, Jesus said, this kind get not forth without fasting and prayer. 5. Anna had what you can call adamant faith.
Anna,
she had strong faith. She challenged God to action. She made a vow to God. And thank God she fulfilled the vow. Then finally, before we start praying now, Anna believed that servant of God.
Anna,
immediately she heard from the mouth of Eli, go in peace. He went away and believed the word of the prophet and broke her fast and became happy. Some of us pray, but we don't believe our prayers are answered. Some of us get the word of knowledge, word of wisdom, they say, well, I've been hearing that before, I don't think it's me. But some will say, I receive it. Sometimes a word comes to a person. The person does not receive it.
And no,
but somebody else catches the overflow and receives it.
As you read,
this is how to move from insult to miracle. In conclusion, beloved, as many people as will have the aggression, the tenacity,
the
faith, and spiritual understanding of
Anna,
God will always remember them and terminate their problems and give them a
Samuel
representing the specific thing that has asked the Lord. Anna had an adversary at home called Penina.
Anna only attacked only later and called Penina.
If she will cry her house out before Penina, it will not move the Penina. The tears will actually be an intoxicating wine to the woman. If she decides to kill herself because of Penina, that's exactly what Penina wanted. If you are getting yourself angry, it will only be another trophy for her in the coven. So you don't do all those useless exercises. And for those who are here, any small thing, you break that and cry. Any small thing, you start crying. Any small thing, you cry. Let me let you understand. Just like my former English teacher in school, he used to say, if beard was to signify intelligence, the goat will have been a genius. And you and I know that the goat is not a genius at all. It is where you say don't go, the goat will go there. So if crying could solve any problem, the whole world would be a big crying arena. Everybody will just be waiting and say, yeah, because if you know, the more you cry, the faster you get breakthrough. Since you have been crying, I didn't have any problem.
Last but you
know, you are just wasting your time. And giving the enemies cause to rejoice. And destroying your health. The Bible now says something very interesting.
Which
many people miss from the book of Isaiah chapter 12. It says, therefore, with joy, shall you draw water out of the well of salvation. Therefore, with joy, shall you draw water out of the well of salvation. Meaning that if you are sad,
unhappy,
every time, you say, mommy, what's the problem?
Mama, kilo unto de.
The strange woman has captured your father. The strange woman will kill you. if you are not careful. What they cannot do by direct witchcraft attack, they do it by making you sad. And when you cry and cry and cry, there is a particular group of demonic spirits. We call them melancholic spirits. You attract them. You are attracting sorrow. Because that's what you are magnetizing. When you are crying because of your problem, I'm praying for somebody here. And Lord will open your understanding in the name of Jesus. Rise to your feet now. All eyes closed. But you see, if you are in this meeting this morning, and you are not born again, you have not surrendered your life to Jesus, I'm here to help you. I want to help you so that one will start Hannah, because we are going to pray Hannah prayers now. When we start Hannah prayers now, I want you to benefit from the Hannah prayers. You are here as a pastor. I want to surrender my life to Jesus. Wherever you are, whether you are in one auditorium or the other, at the back of this place or in the gallery, just find a way quickly to this altar.
Here.
When you are coming, carry your bag and come here. Come and surrender your life to Jesus. You have that great opportunity this morning to surrender your life to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Jesus is waiting for you here very quickly. Thank you, Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back.
No turning back. No turning back. I have decided.
Of you at the altar, I congratulate you. Just bow down your head and see what I'm going to say after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you today, Lord Jesus. Come into my life. Take control of my life. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to pray with you now.
Father,
I thank you for your children here.
Father,
I surrender their lives to you today. Father, keep them standing by your power.
Lay
your hands of fire and power upon them. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Open
your eyes and look at me. You've taken the most important decision in life. Follow this pastor there. God bless you. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Let's
follow the pastor. God bless you in Jesus' name. Let's follow that pastor. God bless you in Jesus' name. On the mountain, in the valley, on the land, and in the sea, on the mountain,
in the valley, on the land, and in the sea.
Hallelujah!
The Lord is my portion in the land of the living. The Lord is good forevermore. The Lord is my portion in the land of the living. The Lord is good forevermore.
On the mountain, in the valley,
on the land, and in the sea, on the mountain, in the valley, on the land and in the sea.
Hallelujah!
The Lord is my portion in the land of the living. The Lord is good forevermore. The Lord is my portion in the land of the living. The Lord is good forevermore.
You are the Lord, that is your name.
You will never share your glory with anyone. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anyone. You will never share your glory with anybody. Almighty God, that is your name.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord, that is your name. You will never share your glory with anyone.
Hallelujah.
You will never share your glory with anybody.
Hallelujah.
Almighty God, that is your name.
Jesus, now you be go.
Oh, Kapata, Pata, now you be go.
Oh,
Kapata, Pata,
Jesus, now you be go.
Oh, Kapata, Pata, now you be go.
Jesus, now you be go.
Oh,
Jesus, now you be go.
Oh, Jesus,
now you be go. Oh, Jesus,
now you be
go.
Oh, Jesus, now you be go. Oh, Jesus,
Ayaya nanando,
abasiya ya ya o.
Ayaya nanando, abasiya ya ya o. Ayaya o, abasiya ya
ya o. Ayaya
nanando.
Kosi lawa lelo wa, mama lawa
lelo wa, patapata.
Kukwa dala,
abala.
Kukwa
dala, yesu lawa lelo wa. Kosi lawa ojo.
The walls of Jericho fell down flat. The children of God are praising the Lord. The walls of Jericho fell down flat. The walls of Jericho fell down flat. The children of God are praising the Lord. The walls of Jericho fell down flat.
Shout hallelujah.
Okay, hallelujah.
All eyes closed.
Ki oju gbogbo wa ni titi.
time for Hannah kind of prayer. Prayer of enough is enough. Let me tell you what's going to be happening within the next 2 minutes. Many will receive the miracle of cancel debt. Many will receive deliverance from inherited poverty. And the get and lose spirits will have to flee. And the power that do not want you to raise your head shall be buried alive. Can you shout this loud and clear? Please don't let anybody's voice be louder than yours. Oh God,
Allah!
By your name, Jah!
And
kill every shame in my life! In the name of Jesus. By your name, Jah. Kill every shame in my life. In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu lagbadura.